The lucrative position of managing trustee for the National Social Security Fund is officially vacant. This follows a Prime Minister's statement after a week of a tussle largely fought through the media, pitting sitting Labour Minister John Munyes and his appointee Fred Rabongo on one side, and the NSSF board and former managing trustee Rachael Lumbasyo on the other.
Generally from the government, I would say, and the government, we have the coalition, you know, government, I would say that I believe I have that backing.
The statement from Prime Minister Raila Odinga's official spokesman Salim Loon states that Raila supports the decision by the Labour Minister as the law recognizes him as the appointing authority. However, he is required to fill the position with an interim managing trustee from within the organization, essentially eliminating Munyes's appointee Fred Rabongo, who was sourced out of NSSF ranks. Raila wants the NSSF board to embark on competitive recruitment of a new managing trustee with the help of a professional external recruiting agency. The Prime Minister has also directed the Inspectorate of State Corporations to investigate all credible allegations of financial fraud, including dealings in securities at the Nairobi Stock Exchange, allegations of nepotism in employment, the payment of inflated legal fees, and the sale of plots adjacent to the Grand Regency Hotel.
If they kill me, they will have access to that money. And I will die as a hero. But we will not allow, and even we have said we are not shielding that lady. If she has done anything wrong, we have CASA, police.
KTN has been unable to confirm who authorized sale of over 50 million KCB shares last week, as the directors denied knowledge of the transaction while the brokers would not disclose such confidential information. Questions that remain unanswered include what information Munyes has over Lumbasyo, especially considering that the board was yet to officially brief him on happenings at the state pensioner. Also, why did the minister pick on Fred Rabongo without consulting the board? Fred Rabongo told KTN of his credentials on phone and that he had submitted his CV alongside those of others. In the meantime, over 2 million members of the organization await findings of investigations and a planned annual general meeting earlier scheduled for November. Samuel Kantai, KTN Late Night.